Assalamu alaikum everyone. In this video, we're hopefully going to cover the topic of static electricity as per the requirements of the GCSE O-level syllabus. Have you ever seen that a balloon stuck to your head, usually in the winter weather, or your sweater makes noises, or you get an electric shock off your doorknob? Or have you ever seen lightning? All of these are the daily examples of the phenomena that we know as static electricity. What is static electricity? Static electricity occurs when there is a buildup of electric charge on the surface of a material. When we are considering this as a material and we are associating it with electricity, we automatically know that this is not restricted to electricity only in conductors, but it can also take place in insulators. Insulators such as plastic, rubber, cloth, and conductors such as any metal surface. It is called static electricity because the charges don't move. What do we mean by this, the charges don't move? When there's a buildup of charges, assume that there's a ball that you have and there's a buildup of charges on that ball, the charges won't be able to circulate throughout that ball, but they will be present only in the outer surface of that ball. We're going to further clarify this concept as we move forward. And the electricity we use every day involves moving charges. Now, in order to understand what is a charge, we need to understand that everything is made up of atoms. Atoms are basically at the smallest unit of matter. So, every atom has three parts. The first part is the electrons. The second part is the proton and the neutron. Now, let's take this as an example. The neutrons and the protons sit inside together in the nucleus of an atom. And the electrons are able to move freely in the outer shells. Only one is shown right here, but there are many shells depending on different atoms. So basically, as we know that the protons and neutrons are situated here and the electrons are situated on the outer shells, we can deduce that electrons will be able to leave this outer shelf and move to another atom's outer shelf. And protons and neutrons will not be able to be separated that easily from an atom because they sit in the nucleus. So we need to keep this thing in mind that the electrons are those parts of the atom that can move and that can be transferred from one atom to another. Now, charges are of two types. Now the electron has negative charge and the proton has positive charge. The neutron has no charge. So the electrons is negatively charged. The protons are positively charged, and we have the neutrons that are neutral. Now, when we say that an atom is neutral, we mean that they have the same number of electrons and the same number of protons, and we don't care how many number of neutrons that it has because it is already neutral. So the same number of electrons and protons will make an atom neutral. Now, how do charges behave? Opposite charges attract and like charges repel. Opposite charges such as the positive and the negative charges will attract, and the like charges such as negative negative or positive positive will always repel. Two positive charges put together will repel each other, and put a positive charge near a negative charge and they will attract each other. Now this third phenomena right over here, a charged object may even attract a neutral one, is related to charging by induction, and we're going to study about it later in this chapter. The first type of charging that we have is charging by friction. Now charging, we already know that friction is a force that develops between two moving objects. In charging by friction, we can have insulators that can obtain or give out their charges. Let's see how it happens. In this example, we have a balloon and we have a ball. These two are in contact. They are going to be rubbed together and they develop a force of friction. then this is a more simplified diagram to show you that there are charges that were already present on this ball and the balloon gained some of the negative charges. When the balloon gained some of the negative charges after being rubbed with the ball, it has more negative charges, so it is negatively charged. And as this ball lost the negative charges, it is now positively charged. This causes a force of attraction to develop between these two objects because we have negative and positively charged objects which are bound to attract. So there is static electricity present between these two objects. So the static electricity is the imbalance of positive and negative charges that causes balloons to stick to the walls. Balloons can stick to the walls usually in winters. Then your hair to stand on end when brush your hair on a dry day. And when you're going to brush your hair, you're actually causing friction to develop between your hair. Some of the electrons will be lost from your hair and brush will be gaining those electrons, and hair will be positively charged, brush will be negatively charged, and they both will then attract. Electric shock you can sometimes get from the door handle. All of these things usually happen in winters. Winters has dry weather and summer have moist weather. So now we're going to link this to dry or moist weather. So basically what happens? When you brush your hair tend to stand like this if there is a brush present near your hair, usually in the winter weather. Why does it not happen in the humid weather or the summer weather? In the summer weather, there is moisture present in the air. Due to that moisture, the water molecules will develop on the surface of your hair and on the surface of the brush as well. We won't be able to see them from our naked eye, but they are already present over there. Those water molecules are going to gain the charges that might be produced because of this brushing of hair. When those molecules will gain the charge, then neither the brush will become negatively charged or the hair will become positively charged. And thus, there won't be any force of attraction between the two objects, and the hair won't stand like this on a moist, sunny day.